Gildan Media, a division of Recorded Books, presents Absolute Essentials of Entrepreneurship by Nerys Fuller Love, narrated by Gabrielle Baker. Full of relevant theory and practical examples of contemporary entrepreneurship, this book is highly recommended. Ian Phillis, Professor of Entrepreneurship, Liverpool John Moores University. 1. Introduction. Summary. Entrepreneurship is defined as being alert to opportunities, willing to take risks, being creative and innovative, and starting a new business. The original meaning of the word entrepreneur is someone who takes between, i.e., buys goods at one price and sells at another, with the aim of making a profit. Other aspects include vision and leadership, independence and being proactive, as well as organizing the factors of production. The contributions to the economy includes job creation, innovation, and new forms of production and organization. Entrepreneurship has developed over time, from the merchants who took enormous risks to establish trade routes to the very successful technology entrepreneurs today. The entrepreneurial process includes identifying the problem, assessing the market potential, and organizing the finance and other resources required to start a new venture. The meaning of the term entrepreneurship has widened over time to describe anyone who has new ideas and can make things happen in the public and not-for-profit sectors. How to use this book? This book is intended to provide a short textbook with the essential elements for the study of entrepreneurship. It includes a simplified presentation of the relevant theories and concepts. Topics included in this text include entrepreneurship theories, entrepreneurial behavior and personality, female and minority entrepreneurship, enterprise culture, opportunity recognition, and entrepreneurial strategies. The essentials of entrepreneurship are presented in short form by introducing the main themes and concepts in a condensed way. Students, in particular, will appreciate being able to use a short textbook to study for examinations. The structure and scope fits in with the way that the subject is taught, in that it is in short sections with tables and illustrations. All the chapters include an executive summary at the beginning. Other resources, including presentations, are available for lectures. There are examples/mini case studies in each chapter. Online support is available, including PowerPoint presentations, longer case studies, and teaching activities. Background. Why do we need to study entrepreneurship? Entrepreneurs can contribute to the prosperity of a region, and there are many examples of large multinational companies that were started as small enterprises. Entrepreneurship is one of the fundamental elements in all economies. The majority of large multinational companies have started as small enterprises, the vision of one or two entrepreneurs. Successful entrepreneurs can reap financial rewards as well as being recognized for their achievements and contributions to society. However, there are also many entrepreneurs who operate on a very small scale, barely making a living. Successive governments in the UK and all over the world have policies to encourage and support entrepreneurship. The motivation for making a region or a country more entrepreneurial is to create employment and innovation. Entrepreneurs can also reinvigorate an economy and bring in new ideas and developments. Entrepreneurship. What is entrepreneurship? There is a general consensus that it is about being innovative, taking a risk, and starting a new business. Gartner defined entrepreneurship as the creation of a new organization and said that research on entrepreneurship should focus on the behavioral rather than the personality aspects. One of the fundamental questions is the relationship between small businesses and entrepreneurship. Although today, entrepreneurship has been widened to include large organizations in both the public and the private sector, the main focus is on the creation of a new enterprise. In a small firm, only one person or a small group of people are in control, and it is this role that is defined as entrepreneurship. There is some discussion as to whether lifestyle entrepreneurs, i.e., those who only want to create an income for themselves, are entrepreneurial. Drucker drew the distinction between small business and entrepreneurship and said that not all small businesses could be considered entrepreneurial. He acknowledged that someone opening a new business, such as a restaurant, is taking a risk, but they are not creating something new, whereas McDonald's created a new method of delivery and a new market. Entrepreneurial activities. Arbitrage. Buying goods at one price and selling at another, with the intention of making a profit on the exchange. Opportunities. Alertness to ideas and opportunities. Innovation. Developing new products and services, as well as new markets and new ways of production. Raising finance / capitalist. Investing own money as well as raising external finance. New business. Starting and growing a new business and creating new jobs. Risk and uncertainty. Bearing the risk and uncertainty of failure. Forecasting demand. Ability to foresee and create demand for products and services. Leadership. Having a vision and be able to motivate and inspire people. Management. Organizing the factors of production and the resources needed. Creativity. Can create something out of nothing. Control. Control over one's actions and time. Vision. Having a long-term vision for the business. Independence. Independent decision-making. Proactivity. Initiating action and pursuing a strategic vision. Persistence. Carrying on despite setbacks and failure. Profit. Profit is the reward for the risks taken. The meaning has developed over the years. The word entrepreneur comes from the French and literally translated means take between. This is the original concept of the entrepreneur, as one who buys at one price and sells at another and makes a profit on the exchange. However, the entrepreneur will not necessarily make a profit every time, and therefore there is an element of risk in each transaction. However, there has been some consensus of what entrepreneurship entails. Entrepreneurship and economic growth. One of the reasons for looking at entrepreneurship is the contribution to economic development. These include the creation of new jobs, innovation in developing new or improved products and services, and new markets. Governments target the small business sector in the hope that they can reduce unemployment. From the economics perspective, there is equilibrium when supply equals demand at a particular price, and markets are based on this premise. This leaves little room for entrepreneurship and small businesses, as the market would be dominated by large firms, which are more efficient. Economists see entrepreneurship as a response to the inefficiencies of the large firms and the entrepreneur as the coordinator of production. Over the centuries, entrepreneurship has thrived in different parts of the world and at different times. Merchants who crossed the oceans in search of commercial exchange were responsible for building empires and developing regions. Cities were built around the important ports, and these traders were richly rewarded for the risks. Parts of the world developed at different times, and from the 17th to the 20th century, it was the growth of the cities that provided opportunities for growth. The Low Countries in the 17th century focused on international trade and art, Britain in the 18th century with the Industrial Revolution, East Asia in the 20th century, and the US in the 21st century, with the developments in computer technology and social media. Although it is possible to identify innovations that have had a major impact, one of the issues in assessing the importance of entrepreneurship to the economy is collecting accurate data. Some of the data used include numbers of self-employed, the numbers of small and medium-sized enterprises, companies registered and deregistered, VAT registrations, number of employees, number of patents registered, etc. None of these provide an accurate indication of the level of entrepreneurship in an economy. There is also the issue of identifying the gazelles, i.e., those that are going to grow and create employment, and how many fail or barely survive. What is clear is that entrepreneurship does play an important role in the economy, and there are many factors at play, including the entrepreneurs themselves, infrastructure, culture, as well as government policies. Case study: Marks and Spencer. Marks and Spencer is a well-established British retailer, with shops all over the UK and in other countries. Michael Marks, a Polish refugee, and Thomas Spencer started the business with a market stall in 1884 in Leeds. A man called Isaac Dewhurst lent Marks £5 to start the business. Their market stall was called the Penny Bazaar because everything was a penny, similar in concept to the pound shops today. The business was originally built on selling British-made clothes sold under its own brand. The company had a policy of giving full refunds on its products, although this has now been changed. The clothes had a reputation for being of good quality and value for money. The company started selling food in 1931. For discussion. 1. How important was the £5 investment to start the business? 2. Why are immigrants more likely to be entrepreneurial? 3. What was its unique selling point? Exercise. Discuss the advantages and disadvantages of starting a business with a market stall. Find other entrepreneurs who have started a business in this way. The entrepreneur. What type of person starts their own business? What are the characteristics of the entrepreneur? The general perception is someone who exploits a market opportunity and makes a profit. The term entrepreneur has been used to cover a wide range of activities, including self-employment, small business ownership, as well as entrepreneurial activities in large organizations. Entrepreneurs can also develop new products or services and create new markets as well as new methods of production. They often have to take creative approaches to solving problems due to a lack of resources, especially financial, and they have to find better and cheaper ways of doing things. New businesses are required to provide jobs, innovate and create the big businesses of the future. The key people in this process are the people who start their own businesses, the entrepreneurs. There are often negative images of these entrepreneurs, of them exploiting their workers and trying to make a quick profit. However, since the 1980s, the contribution that entrepreneurs can make to the economy has been recognized. Baumol describes the entrepreneur as an innovator who can transform an idea into an economically viable entity. Starting a new business involves personal responsibility, identifying a market opportunity and taking financial risk. However, entrepreneurs, like the small businesses themselves, are very diverse. Their motivations for starting a business also vary. The entrepreneur is the person who spots an opportunity, raises the money, and brings together the people and the facilities needed to start the business. Entrepreneurs are highly motivated people who are willing to take risks and make things happen. They are not always driven by the need to make a profit, although the desire to make money and improve their lifestyle is an important factor. Entrepreneurs are all different, and they each take a different approach to starting their business. The entrepreneur is willing to take risks, but often in a considered way, balancing the risk with the rewards. They often take ingenious ways to overcome obstacles to starting a business. Although entrepreneurship has traditionally been associated with starting and running a business, it is also used, in a more general sense, to describe someone as entrepreneurial in large organizations, in the public sector, and in the community. The entrepreneur is creative and innovative and is able to start a business, develop new projects, raise financing, as well as organize and manage the business on a day-to-day basis. Some entrepreneurs are better at starting a business than running it on a day-to-day basis, and they will transfer the management as soon as possible. Other entrepreneurs are happy to keep their business at a manageable level and stay in control. Entrepreneurs have vision, commitment, passion, and tenacity, and are able to inject these values into their business. Many small startup businesses are now household names. Many companies, for example, Monsoon, started off with a market stall. The ability to create a team is an important element in the success of these businesses, together with an understanding of the requirements of their customers. However, one of the main characteristics of successful entrepreneurs is that they have not given up when they faced serious problems, and some have failed in a previous business before finding success. Entrepreneurship is seen by successive governments as a way of reducing unemployment. The objective in more recent years, however, has been to identify businesses that are going to grow rather than encourage everyone to start a business. This is because of the high failure rate of small firms, and also because these firms are the ones that are going to create employment. Although there is a general perception that entrepreneurs are willing to take risks, the entrepreneurs themselves often describe themselves as risk-averse. However, they are generally very self-confident and sure that their idea will work. Possibly they have a different viewpoint to other people in that they are confident that their business will be a success. There is clearly an element of financial risk, and if the entrepreneur's home is used as security for a loan, other people would not be willing to take this risk. Creating opportunities. The entrepreneur needs to be constantly seeking new opportunities. However, identifying an opportunity is not enough, and the entrepreneur also needs to be able to exploit them. In order to make a profit, the entrepreneur needs to identify opportunity where the returns are high enough to justify the investment of time, money, and resources. One of the characteristics of entrepreneurs is their optimism. Some entrepreneurs may be over-optimistic about the potential of their ideas. The high failure rate for new businesses indicates that possibly the entrepreneur's forecasts for sales and profits are often overestimated. However, the over-optimism may be an important element in the entrepreneurial process, as this may make it easier to raise finance and obtain other resources that may lead to success. In order to transform an opportunity into reality, entrepreneurs also have to have a high degree of motivation. This is because they are going to encounter difficulties and setbacks as they establish their business. McClelland identified that those with a high need for achievement may be more likely to exploit opportunities. There are also people who work in large organizations who identify opportunities for exploitation, and they may develop these within the existing structure. Entrepreneurship over time. Over the centuries, the term entrepreneurship has developed from Adam Smith's capitalist to the wider understanding today of someone who is creative and opportunistic. Originally, entrepreneurs were merchants who bought at one price and sold at another. These merchants developed trade all over the world, and all trading took place originally in markets. The perception of entrepreneurship over the years, especially in the media, has changed from the original capitalists who invested in industries. The understanding and definitions have changed over time. Today, entrepreneurship can also be found in the public sector and not-for-profit enterprises. Starting a business in order to make a profit has been an integral part of the definition of entrepreneurship through the centuries. By definition, organizations in the public sector and social enterprises do not necessarily have profits as their raison d'être. Therefore, although they may have a surplus to invest in their organizations, they do not face risk and uncertainty in the same way as entrepreneurs who have started their own businesses. The media have often portrayed entrepreneurs as shady characters, ready to focus on making money in the short term. Successful entrepreneurs have a vision and focus on the long term, often with a view of passing on the business to their children. In the television program Only Fools and Horses, Del Boy bottles the tap water in his council flat to sell it as Peckham spring water. Although he has many ideas of how to make money, none of them succeed, and he only gets rich by winning the lottery. Entrepreneurs' innovations have changed people's lives. Innovation, according to Drucker, needs to be systematic and does not happen by chance. There are many examples, such as James Dyson, who developed his prototype bagless vacuum cleaner for a number of years before he was successful. Some innovations are often not completely new ideas, but improvements to products or services that were already in existence. There are many entrepreneurs who have taken an existing concept and refined it. An example of this is Mark Zuckerberg, one of the founders of Facebook. The idea was developed by the Winklevoss brothers, but it was Zuckerberg and his co-founders who developed the company into what it is today. The entrepreneurial process. Entrepreneurs often start by identifying a problem. E.g., James Dyson thought that the existing vacuum cleaners were inefficient and decided to develop a cyclone technology that did not need bags. Once entrepreneurs have identified the problem, they can see if there's an opportunity, i.e., if there is a market for the product or service. They can then develop the idea and, if it looks feasible, then they can invest their own money or raise finance to start a new venture. They can then either decide to work on their own and build an external team or take on new staff. New venture creation. The rate of new firm startups varies across industries, and some may be more attractive than others due to high profitability and low barriers to entry. However, low barriers to entry may increase competition, and this may squeeze profits and result in failures. The question of whether entrepreneurship can exist in a large organization is an interesting one. Drucker stated that entrepreneurship can be found in large organizations such as Marks and Spencer, although this is based on introducing innovation. It is clear that some entrepreneurial activities exist in large organizations, and often they are successful if they can mimic the small business and start a new venture within the existing structure. However, the main issue with this understanding of entrepreneurship is the absence of investment and risk. The other issue is that, in order to support and encourage entrepreneurship, governments have to target their support at small businesses. There are different types of small businesses. There are the entrepreneurial businesses that are innovative and change the existing market structures, and the small business owners who own the majority of small firms, such as shops and franchisees, and who are happy to run their business on a small scale. One of the most important functions of entrepreneurship is bringing together the factors of production, including people, and sourcing supplies and equipment. However, the ability to raise finance is considered essential if the business is to grow. There are some examples of firms that have grown without an external finance, including Tetra Pak. The majority of businesses will not be able to generate sufficient internal funds, especially in the early stages. Cash is needed both for fixed assets such as equipment, vehicles and premises, as well as working capital to purchase supplies and to pay the wages. Many entrepreneurs start a business with their own savings, such as Charles Dunstan, who started Carphone Warehouse with £6,000 that he had saved in his job as a sales manager. One of the fundamentals of entrepreneurship, particularly from the economic theory point of view, is profit. Knight developed a theory of profit based on the entrepreneur buying goods now and selling at a profit in the future. However, he later stated that the profits had to be made over a specific period of time, i.e., an accounting period. From an accounting point of view, profit is the difference between income and expenses and is stated in the profit and loss statement that covers a period of time. Creating an entrepreneurial society is seen as a priority for governments, as new ventures are seen as essential for a vibrant economy. Small businesses are an important source of new jobs. They can also provide jobs for sectors of the workforce that would otherwise find it difficult to find employment, such as young people and disadvantaged groups. New businesses can also diversify the economy and revitalize geographical areas. Case study: Alan Sugar. Alan Sugar, now Lord Sugar, is now famous for the Apprentice television program, where would-be entrepreneurs compete for the investment to start their own business. He grew up in a council flat in East London and left school at 16 years old. His first business venture was selling beetroots that he had cooked. Later on, he started selling aerials from the boot of a car in the market. By the late 1960s, Alan Sugar had founded Amstrad, the name is based on his initials, which sold hi-fi sound systems and personal computers and word processors. His target market was the lorry driver and his wife, who wanted a computer with just one plug. The strategy was to develop electronics at a cheaper price, based on older technology and manufacturing techniques. The first computers and the word processor were a success, and this provided the basis for Sugar's fortune. However, subsequent products such as the emailer, a combined telephone and emailing machine, were not successful. Other products included a gaming console and satellite dishes for Sky, and in 2007, Amstrad was sold to BSkyB for £125 million. For discussion. 1. Is Alan Sugar a typical entrepreneur? 2. What was his approach to technology? Exercise. Prepare an exercise for the Apprentice television show to develop and assess entrepreneurial skills in the candidates. Entrepreneurial leadership and management. Leadership includes inspiring and motivating people to follow. Some character traits can contribute towards effective leadership, and these can overlap with those of the entrepreneur. The meaning of leadership is to decide on the path ahead and supporting and informing followers of the direction in which they are traveling. An entrepreneurial leader.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.